Why do people get injured? Today's video is giving you a couple of big points and big factors as to why people may get injured. And also at the end, like I try and do as much as I can, is give you some take-home tips you can do to either avoid injury or help people recover a lot quicker. So big things why people might get injured. First of all, is previous injury. That's probably the biggest factor as to dictating whether someone might pick up a future injury. If they've had pain in the past, an injury in the past, they're a lot more likely to get re-injured. That's the first thing we've got to be aware of. Second point then would be to looking at general load management and how they design a program, or if they even have any sort of program at all. Quite often people are just doing too much. So I always like to look at the actual dosage of something. You know, are they running 10 miles a day and their body just isn't conditioned for it? So looking at load management would be a really good place to start when you look at trying to reduce injury or helping someone get out of pain. Next then we'll be looking at just joints and tissue getting overloaded. This links a little bit into the load management side of things, but also looks a little bit into the mechanics and how someone actually moves. And this is where the argument goes for looking at movement and movement variety. Because even if you've got something quite repetitive, like again, running is a really good example to use today, is that we think we're going to move the same every single time, but there's going to be slight varieties and slight sort of subtleties in how we move. So if we look at the ankle joint, for example, and we realise that actually it doesn't want to move in one fixed way, it needs to sort of roll in and roll out. We need to have good range of motion, good dorsiflexion as the ankle pronates and supinates. So without getting too technical, the main take-home point is to realise that when we look at mechanics and joints and tissue getting overloaded and injured, we might want to give people some different options and some variety in their movement. So look at how they move and can they move in different ways. Really common cause of back pain is people only move in one fixed way and they overload their back time and time again. Next point then is, what are people doing for recovery? Are they addressing recovery? One question I ask a lot of people is, what do you do for stress management? What do you do to relax? And quite often people come back with nothing. So stress management, are they getting enough sleep? What's their nutrition like? Again, linking into program design, do they actually deload? Where do they rest? Would they have like a take it easy week? Do they ever do that? And the last point of why people might get injured, and it's one we can't really avoid too much, people playing sports and stuff, might be just direct trauma, direct impact. So what are some tips we can use? What are some take-home tips you can use right now to help prevent the injury or definitely address maybe common injuries people have got? So first thing would be to take a gradient approach to exercise. So a gradient approach, what we're basically saying is building up slowly over time. That sounds like a really common sense thing to say. But we tend to think of it as purely sort of just load management. And load management is only one side of a gradient approach. We also need to think about lots of other variables. So how does someone move? Like I mentioned earlier, can you give them some variety? Can we address speed? Might be useful for runners. Could we address range of motion? That could be a potentially one good way to go. Motor control. So lots of ways of building up exercise slowly over time and not just using load as one variable. Now that links very much into program design. Do they actually have a design in the program? Is it built up slowly over time? Are they having recovery weeks within that program design, or enough rest days and recovery days? Again, doesn't have to be too technical. It could be really, really basic. You could just say to people, look, this week just stick at, say, 3 miles if they're running, and the next week build up a mile or two. It sounds really obvious, but very often, the big things are people just doing too much. The dosage is too high for a lot of people. Next point then, something I mentioned earlier, variety of movement. Can we tweak movement a little bit? So could we look at the ankle joint and just give people some different options of moving it in some different ways so the same tissues aren't always getting overloaded? And the last point, guys, would be just, are people generally recovering enough? What can you give people? What tips can you give people to help them recover quicker? Again, think about it holistically. Think about the bigger picture. Okay guys, so these are really key things to think about today. Rewatch the video if you need to. These are the big kind of elephant in the room things. We're very guilty of kind of going all, sometimes sort of down rabbit holes and getting too geeky and looking at kind of how a core is firing or certain small muscles. Look at the big things. Look at dosage. Have they had a previous injury? Can they move in different ways? If you can address these things as well as their recovery, I know you're going to get people to move and feel and get out of pain and recover from their injuries a lot quicker.